James Wild Bill Hickok. Hickok is said to have been a great shot, even as a youngster, and was well known for his marksmanship with a pistol. In 1865, Wild Bill was involved in an iconic public quick draw duel with David Tutt. Harper's Magazine featured it in a story, which elevated Hickok to hero status. Hickok's weapons of choice were a brace of 1851 Colt pistols with ivory handles and silver plating, which he kept in his belt or sash and drew in a reverse cavalry style. On April 15, 1871, Hickok took over as the Marshal of Abilene, Texas. However, in December that same year, he was discharged of his duties following a string of dubious shooting incidents, including the accidental killing of his deputy. After that, Hickok traveled with Buffalo Bill Cody's Wild West Show for a few years, performing as himself. Fate caught up with Hickok on August 2, 1876, when a man named Jack McCall walked into the Deadwood, Dakota saloon in which Hickok was playing poker and shot him in the head from behind. William Curly Bill Brocious. Curly Bill Brocious may well have been Arizona's most famous or infamous outlaw. He was involved in multiple gunfights and related incidents, including the accidental shooting of Tombstone Town Marshal Fred White on October 27, 1880, and the March 8, 1881 killing of a cowboy named Dick Lloyd. Brocious may have also been mixed up in the March 18, 1882 assassination of Morgan Earp. Whether or not this was the case, what is certain is that Brocious was good with a gun. In fact, a contemporary said he was capable of shooting coins from between people's fingers and could comfortably take down a fleeing jackrabbit. He was also said to have the ability to snuff out a candle by firing at it with his pistol. In the end, though, on March 24, 1882, White Earp killed Brocious during a shootout involving the Earp posse, Brocious, and several other cowboys in Iron Springs, Arizona. Dallas Studenmeyer. Armed with two guns, Studenmeyer was an accurate shot with both hands, and he had a reputation for being tough and dangerously short-tempered when he had a drink inside him. In April 1881, Studenmeyer became Marshal of El Paso, Texas, this being an infamously lawless and violent town at the time. On his third day on the job, Studenmeyer killed three men with two .44 caliber Colt revolvers in a famous incident known as the Four Dead in 5 Seconds gunfight. By February the following year, he had dispatched with a further seven men in gunfights. Although the crime rate in El Paso fell significantly, and Studenmeyer earned himself repute as a legendary lawman and gunslinger, he also made himself a lot of enemies. On September 18, 1882, he was shot and killed during a shootout with the Manning brothers, the culmination of a feud. He was 36 years old. Luke Short. Fast-drawing gunslinger and killer Luke Short was born in Mississippi in 1854, but was raised in Texas. Short had practiced with a gun in his early years and would acquire a reputation for his skill. But the most famous event he was involved in was probably the so-called Dodge City War. After buying shares in the Long Branch Saloon, Short was branded undesirable by the Dodge City authorities, and they made attempts to get rid of him. However, determined not to go down without a fight, Short reached out to prominent Old West lawman Bat Masterson, who in turn got in touch with Wyatt Earp. Earp then descended on Dodge City with a posse of desperados. And in order to prevent any conflict, Short was allowed back into Dodge and given permission to reopen his saloon. Short is also famous for winning a duel against Jim Courtblight on February 8, 1887 in Fort Worth, Texas, where his ability to pull a pistol saved his own life and ended Courtblight's. Harvey Kid Curry Logan. Born in Tama County, Iowa in 1867, Harvey Logan, otherwise known as Kid Curry, was caught up in criminal activities such as robbery from a young age. Logan would ride with outlaw Black Jack Ketchum, form his own gang, and eventually join Butch Cassidy and the Sundance Kid's Wild Bunch. According to some, Logan was considered the fastest gun in the West, and is thought to be the basis for the Sundance Kid character as depicted by Hollywood. Logan participated in a series of robberies in South Dakota, Wyoming, New Mexico, and Colorado, and some claim he was the wildest of the wild bunch. Logan escaped from prison on two occasions and allegedly killed 9 men in various shooting incidents during his time. In the end, on June 17, 1904, Logan took his own life after being wounded in a gunfight in Parachute, Colorado, perhaps to evade capture one last time.